Hey guys, how are you? So today I wanted to talk to you about my favorite high-end foundations. If you've seen my channel, you know that I love doing foundation reviews. That is one of my passions. The first one, and the one that I think it's a staple for almost everybody on YouTube and everybody and their mother, is the Estée Lauder Double Wear. This is just a great foundation all around. Let's talk about the pros. One of the pros about this foundation is definitely the coverage, which is extremely, extremely high. The other pro is the long wear. It just lasts from the moment you put it on until the last second that you take it off. It could be 12 hours and this foundation still looks impeccable. The next pro about this foundation is the finish, which is a matte finish. One of the negatives about this foundation is definitely the packaging. I feel like the glass packaging without a pump is just not practical at all in terms of traveling with it or dispensing the actual product. Sometimes you get too much, sometimes you get too little, and it's just not practical at all. I think they should really evolve, and just for the price that you're paying for this foundation, you should definitely improve the packaging. The next foundation that I really wanted to talk about was this Dermablend Smooth Indulgence Foundation. If you've seen my channel, well, actually, if somebody asked me, what is one foundation that you could keep and nothing else, it would be this foundation. I love it. One of the pros is the finish. Well, no, the coverage. It's extremely high. This is absolute coverage. The next thing that I love about this is the finish, which is a natural finish. It's not nearly as matte as the Double Wear, but it's still, you don't need to set it with a powder, so I feel like this is a really good, if you really need that high coverage, this is a really good everyday foundation. The next thing that I love about this is the packaging. Super hygienic, super easy. It's plastic, really easy to travel with. All around a good foundation. There's really nothing negative that I have to say about it. I am in the color Wheat. For this Estée Lauder Double Wear, I'm in the color Dawn 53. The next foundation that I wanted to talk to you about is the Laura Mercier Smooth Indulgence Silk Cream Foundation. I'm talking too fast because I don't want this video to be super long. This foundation is super good. So the pros is the coverage, which is extremely high. Another is the long wear of the foundation. The next one is the packaging, which is exactly what I love. It's plastic and it's got a little squeezy thing that you can just take your foundation on however much you want and you're not worrying about wasting too much foundation. The next thing is actually a con, which is, well, one of the pros is the finish, which is natural, okay? The negative about this foundation, which is, I don't know if it's really a negative, it's a negative for me, is the fact that this foundation can very easily look cakey. Even though you don't really need that much to begin with, but if you kind of put on too much at the beginning or start putting it on and on and on and on, it can definitely look cakey pretty easily, so you have to really, really be careful with application. The next foundation that I wanted to talk to you about is the one that I'm wearing right now. It's my most recent find, and you actually won't be able to find a review of this in my channel, but one is coming up soon. So, you know, if you're looking for a matte finish foundation, it's actually what I have on my face right now, and I really, really like it. So let's talk about the pros. The pros is the finish, which is a matte finish. It's amazing. It's really, whether, like, even though it's matte, it's not too powdery, and it's just a really good everyday type of finish. Another pro for this foundation is the long wear. It really lasts impeccably from the moment you put it on until the moment you take it off. The next thing that I want to talk is the packaging, which obviously is the kind of packaging that I like. It's very light. I think it looks very cute, and it's just very hygienic. One of the negatives, which is really not a negative for anybody, for everybody, it's kind of like a negative for me, is that this foundation is quite pricey. It costs $46, but the coverage is not that high. So if you can see, I still have like a lot of dark spots from all of that acne thing that I had. And while this foundation is a medium coverage, you're really not gonna get any more than that. So that's a negative for me. But I still use it as an everyday foundation because I feel like it's such a good finish. It lasts for such a long time and it's pretty natural. So yeah, there's that one. Finally, I wanted to talk about my Sephora Airbrush Foundation. Oh, I'm so sorry, guys. I'm horrible at this. In the Laura Mercier, I am Sand Beige. In the Becca, I am Noisette. And in this one, I am Medium, okay? So, the pros about this foundation is the coverage was extremely high, the long wear of the foundation, which is extremely long, and the finish, which is semi-matte. Okay, so this is a foundation that you can totally use during special events, and it's just gonna look impeccable. It's gonna make your skin look great, and it's gonna last all throughout the event. One of the negatives, which is really not a negative, you just have to kind of work with it, is the application. I really, really, really encourage you to watch my video and all of the videos that you can find about how people apply this foundation, because people do it in many different ways, and there's kind of like a trick to finding the right application for you with this foundation. Some people apply it on their hands and then put it on their faces. Some people put it directly on their face, which is my preferred method, but you just have to be really careful about your hair and your clothes. So there's definitely like a learning curve with this foundation in terms of application, but it's such a good foundation that it's definitely, definitely worth it. So yeah, guys, those are my favorite drops. High-end foundations. I hope you liked it. Let me know what your favorite foundations are. I am always looking for better new foundations to try. So that's it for me, and I will see you in the next video, okay? Bye.